Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Summer of Carnage right here in the Venom Vlog. This is episode 433, I believe now, and we are going to look at Miles Morales, Absolute Carnage number 3. This is the final issue in this miniseries that Saladin Ahmed is writing and Federico Vincentini is doing the art for, and it's good. I mean, it's a pretty solid issue. The only downside is I read this last night, reread it last night, because I kind of flipped through it on Friday when I got it at the show while I was waiting in line for something. I was like, oh, I'll flip through it a little bit, but I really dove into it last night, and then I read Absolute Carnage 4 this morning, and I was bummed. I was really bummed that there was basically a pretty good setup in this that isn't really paid off in Absolute Carnage 4. It was a little bit of a bummer, so we're going to get into that a little bit. We'll talk more about it in Absolute Carnage 4 video, which will be next, but for this one, I was like, oh, so, you know, before we get into it, before I spoil anything, because I might spoil this issue, you know, I may just, you know, talk about some of the stuff that happens in it, because it's, I don't know, I just, I felt like on the fence. I was like, wow, I feel like I was really liking this issue. And then issue 4 of Absolute Carnage kind of took out the steam from it. And that's a real bummer. I almost kind of wish I didn't read Absolute Carnage 4 before recording this. But of course, you know, I wanted to get up on all the books so I can record all these in succession today and get them up as fast as possible, because we're like a week and a half behind now. So I'm trying to, like, you know, catch up. But before I give away, you know, anything about this book, boom, there's the digital code. First person to put the code in obviously gets the comic book. And if you did get the code, let me know what your review is of Miles Morales number 3 in the comments below. And everyone else who's read this book, same thing, because we're probably going to get into spoilers down there. But I might talk about some in this video too. I'm just going to kind of wing it. But, you know, this starts off and it ends, you know, picks up where the last issue ended, where Miles is a Carnage symbiote. He has a Carnage symbiote, you know, covering him, and he's biting J. Jonah Jameson on the collarbone, on the shoulder there, and then Silver Sable shows up to like fight him and kick him off, and then you have Miles struggling with the suit, and he's like, no, I can overcome this, I can be better than this, I can take control. And that's what Miles is doing, and then he starts using his Venom Blast to blast the symbiote off of him. And it's, I'm like, wow, look at that willpower that you know, that he shows, that's so great. And I'm like, yeah, it's, and he's had interactions with symbiotes before, alternate universe ones from the alternate universe obviously, but then also he's dealt with Null and Eddie, you know, early on in Eddie's book too. So I'm like, this is great. This is what I like about Miles. He does have that willpower, that Peter Parker willpower. He can rise up if he's put in a bind. And I was really happy with Saladin writing this, because I was like, oh, good. It didn't come across like too convenient, because sometimes characters feel like, oh, look how powerful they are, and it just feels like for convenience sake. And meanwhile, you have other characters that are like Rogue, who are super powerful, and no one really does anything powerful with her that much, you know? So it's like, it's such a weird balance with comic book stories and writers sometimes. But Saladin, I thought, did a pretty good job here. I like this issue way more than issue 2. Issue 2 was definitely the worst of these three, you know, issues, this series, but I just felt like it just suffered from second act problems, and this kind of brought it home in a way, because, you know, Miles stepping up was really great, fighting back against the symbiote, Silver Sable getting a couple moments, trying to save Jonah, there's some great banter there, which I really liked, and then Happy Dan, that serial killer that Miles mentioned in the first issue, who gets a symbiote in the second issue, and he's running around with Miles, now Miles is trying to save him, and I loved that. He's like, look, I know you're a serial killer, you're a monster, you've hurt people and stuff, he goes, but this thing on top of you is just going to make you way worse, you got to break free, become your own man, and he's trying to save the life of someone who is, you know, far gone, he's trying to deliver a hope, and he's trying to, you know, see the best in people and see that even though Dan is a bad person, he's way worse with the symbiote under Carnage's control, and he's trying to save him. And I'm like, yeah, that it's very naive in some ways, but you know, he's a kid, so it works really well. So I was like, man, I like this. I like that Miles is really trying to save Dan. And he even turns Dan good for like a moment or two, but then J. Jonah Jameson, so the suit that leaves, you know, Miles ends up on J. Jonah Jameson. So now Miles has to fight him towards the end of the book. So, and then, you know, obviously, like I said, Dan gets knocked down. So Miles like webs him up and he's like, all right, I'll leave you here. Hopefully the police will show up. That's where I'm kind of divided on this storyline. In some issues like Scream, it looks like a citywide epidemic of like symbiotes running everywhere. In issue, I think 2 or 3 of Absolute Carnage, they show that scene where Eddie's on the rooftop and you just see a sea of symbiotes running across, you know, this neighborhood. So I'm like, is this all restricted to one neighborhood, Or is this actually like spreading all over New York? Because in some books, like Lethal Protector, kids are still playing out in the street. In this book, Miles crash lands through the window of the sneaker shop from the first issue where he saw those sneakers. And the guy said, "Hey, thanks for saving me and save my story." And he's like, "I'm sorry, I broke your window." And the guy's like, "It's okay, insurance will take care of it. But hey, what can I do to help? You know, can I give you something in return?" And Miles like, "Well, I do kind of like those sneakers." He goes, "But I can't take any gifts." And the guy's like, "Look, come back at some point, Spider-Man, after all this is over. And I'll give you the sneakers as a thank you." And I'm like, that's cool, like a good human little moment there. And I like Miles going like, "I really can't take him, you know, for saving you, blah blah blah." But the guy's like trying to do a nice thing to him, and I'm like, "Oh, that's nice. It's a nice little character moment." But I'm like, "But is the city overrun outside? How's this guy still open for business? Why is he still at his store? Like, why didn't he board it up?" And so it's like these. That's one of the things is I feel like when you do an event book like this, like when Geoff Johns does one for like Blackest Night or you know Infinite Crisis or stuff like that. He talks to the other writers and they kind of come up with a formula. All right, here's what's going to happen. Here's how much of the DC universe or this city is going to be conquered. Here's how much we got to work with. You know, when they did DC Metal, they were like, "All right, we're going to, you know, block off Gotham and that's going to, and, you know, the mountain's going to come up out of the ground and we're going to have characters interact with that mountain and stuff." And you know, so all these things, you know, you have to work out. And I feel like there's such an inconsistency with these books as far as like, how much of a nightmare this is in New York, because every book is different. Every book paints it in a different way. Some paint it as like apocalyptic, you know, nightmare everywhere, symbiotes everywhere, and then other books paint it to where kids are still playing outside in the street while this is going on, and you're just kind of like, what is happening? Like, and that's my biggest issue, and probably with, and I don't know if that's that doesn't solely fall on Donny Cates, but since he's the guy who's creating this event, I feel like some of these books he's just like, you know what? Go write this, and here's a general thing you got to do, and that's, and then I trust you to do the rest. And it's like, that's great. I'm glad you put your faith in these other writers, but those little details matter, and you know, and fans, you know, ultimately want to know how this is all working out. I mean, does it affect the story overall? No, not at all. But we do want to see that much attention paid to these events, so that way we know it's like I'm investing like you know $100, $200 or whatever to buy all these tie-ins. I want to make sure that investment, you know, is worth it. That you guys put in that level of work into these books. And so right now, like this issue, I'm like I see it as if this is a standalone story. But if you tie it in the Absolute Carnage stuff, I don't see it. I don't see the hard work as far as like continuity gets. And that's because in this one, Miles has broken free from the symbiote. And by the end of the book, he is you know, fully himself. And then he makes the decision, though, at the end to take the symbiote off of J. Jonah Jameson and put it back on himself, but he's in full control. So I am going to spoil the final image here. It does show right there, it shows Miles take control of the symbiote. But he's fully in control. And meanwhile, in Absolute, and it says to be continued, obviously not in issue four of this because they're not making an issue four. Unfortunately, I would have liked to seen how he goes from this to what happens in Absolute Carnage number four. But in Absolute Carnage four, Miles Morales is not in control. And Eddie has to save him and pull him from the symbiote in a way. Like he has to talk him into saving himself with the Venom Blast and stuff. And I'm like, but he already did that in this one. So I guess you can easily just go like, oh, but Zeke, okay, he's in control of this one, but like Scream, by the time he gets to the final battle in Absolute Carnage 4, he's not in control anymore. It's like, maybe you can make that argument, but then why pump it up and leave it on this big moment where it's like, I'm gonna go and do something about Carnage and I'm gonna help save the day. And it's like, he kind of does, but not, you know, not in this way, like not in the way that it ends this book on. So that was a little frustrating, but we'll get into that in Absolute Carnage 4. That doesn't really have much to do with this one. I think overall Saladin did a good job, but he really did pump up Miles and gave him like, you know, like he gave him this immense willpower and he gave him these great moments and these great character moments. And he had fun with it. It was like nice, like balance of fun and humor, but also, you know, Miles trying to save people. We don't really know where, you know, Silver Sable and Jonah, you know, go off too much in this one. I mean, it does kind of just wrap things up really quickly, and that's a little frustrating because you're like, oh, these elements were set up, but you kind of want to treat this as a standalone story, one, two, and three. It should have a beginning, middle, and end. And then, you know, okay, well, here's this one thread that now Donny Cates is going to explain in his book. And then the one thread they leave you with isn't really explained in the Absolute Carnage number four book. And there's no real wrap up to some of these other characters. So Maybe Saladin's going to do that in the Miles Morales main monthly series. Potentially, I don't know, or maybe the next issue of Miles Morales will not be a tie-in, but an epilogue to this, and it'll go over what happened. Maybe that's coming, and so maybe I should reserve some of this judgment. But overall, like, this issue on its own was fine. I didn't have problems with the continuity until Absolute Carnage number 4 came out. So we'll get into that in the next episode, because I have a lot to say about that issue. So make sure you stay subscribed so you don't miss out. I'm going to try to pump these up as fast as I can today, and then try to, you know, upload the rest tomorrow. So you'll at least get Amazing Spider-Man, the Miles Morales issue, and Absolute Carnage 4, hopefully today on Wednesday, October 16th. And then the other ones I'll try to get done for Thursday and maybe Friday if I need more time. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts of this issue down below. Overall, like I said, I still liked it. I'd probably give it like a 3.5 out of 5. It was good. It was a solid issue, and I liked Miles in it, and I thought it was a step up from issue 2. But it does leave me with some, you know, issues with Absolute Carnage 4. But I wouldn't say that's completely on Saladin. I would say that's on Donnie Cates. So we'll get to that when we get to there in the next episode. We'll get there when we get there, basically. But that'll be the next episode. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the future. Peace.